Rule number one, I will review every single North American Dreamcast game. Rule number two, time is limited. Rule number three, official hardware only, no emulation, and no imports. Why? I've always wanted to play every single North American Dreamcast game, and today is the 20th anniversary of the release of the Sega Dreamcast. This first section is going to be loosely based on launch games and their sequels. Let's get started.
Soul Calibur.
This game is quite possibly the best game on the Sega Dreamcast. This game is also possibly the best fighting game in the sixth generation of consoles. EGM listed this as number six on the list of the best games of all time. And number two was Tetris. I can't get over this game. The gameplay, story, training mode, moves, graphics, characters. Just watching the intro gives me chills. And if I had to pick a favorite character, it's gotta be Ivy or Die. This game is an easy 10 out of 10. Absolutely fantastic game. Completely original. Great graphics. And it's one of the games that sold me on the Sega Dreamcast when I was 13. My brother and I have played the hell out of this game. I just wish I had more time to talk about it.
Welcome to the Power Stone world.
And yeah, it had a sequel. And it was better. It's crazy! You can play with four people? Absolutely fantastic. And if you're having a party, turn off Smash Bros. And turn on this game. And you'll have a great time. You guys knew it was coming. Sonic Adventure. It's a fantastic game, and it brought me back to the glory days of the Genesis. This game really had it all, and even though a lot of people poorly review it lately, I still think it's a really good game, and I think they're too harsh on it. You know, every game ages. Even Mario 64 has aged to a certain extent. I think an underrated aspect of this game is that Amy's character is actually a lot of fun to play. I would like to see a whole game with her playstyle. Sonic Adventure 2 is more or less the same game, and it's pretty damn fantastic. What I will say is that sometimes it was kind of a bummer when I had to play as Knuckles or Tails, when I really wanted to play as Sonic. Sonic Shuffle is one of those games I really want to like, and I keep trying. But the game's just not all that great. The problem with these, like, Mario Party games is that everybody has turns and it just takes so long to get to the minigames. And the minigames are the best part, but there's so much loading. This is just one of those games that, you know, you're playing with your friends and you all just kind of lose interest after about 20 minutes. I would give this game a 6.5 out of 10. Pen Pen Triicelon. This is a simple but entertaining kids game. You're going to pick a Pen Pen, decorate them, and run, slide, or swim to the finish. It's not very deep, but it's fun in short bursts. I would recommend playing this with kids or with a couple of friends, but it's not very deep. Blue Stinger. Now, I wish I had 10 or 15 minutes I could talk about this game. There is a lot to unpack here. It is a survival horror game, but it's very, very campy. You can also pick up your favorite Pen Pen. And yeah, I'm just going to leave it at that. I would recommend playing this game, or at least trying it. And from what I've seen, it's not that bad of a game, but it's not a must-have.
What are you doing? Did you go to Rad's place?
I love these kind of chicks.
You know, at this point, nothing surprises me anymore.
Hydro Thunder!
This is an arcade-style racer with boosts and boats. There's a lot of little tricks, a lot of little secret areas, and it's a fantastic game. I would highly recommend that you find a buddy and you just race each other and have a great night. Now, there's an Xbox Live Arcade reimagining on the 360 and Xbox One, which is a good game in its own way, too different for my taste.
Four Wheel Thunder!
Four Wheel Thunder was a spiritual successor, I guess, even though it was released around the same time. It was also made by Midway, but it's just big trucks and boosts. Same overall game plan. It's not as good. I wouldn't recommend it as much, but it is surprisingly fun. This one's going to get a 7.5 out of 10. Flag to Flag. This game is just okay. It's kind of generic. Doesn't really have anything that stands out to me. The best thing about this game to me was the music. It's solid, but there's just better games to play. I'm going to give it a 6 out of 10. Oh my god, this game sucks. I'm actually surprised that it's this bad. And it's all down to the controls. The controls. The horrible controls. I'm actually trying to drive here in this footage, and as you can see, it's quite difficult. Now, I thought to myself, well, maybe retro mode's gotta be better. Nope. It's worse. It's much worse. This one's gonna get the worst game on the Dreamcast for me. At least, it's gotta be in the top 5. I mean, this game is horrible. Aero Wings is a flight simulator on the Sega Dreamcast. Has complicated controls, and is not pick up and play. Personally, I didn't like this game, and the voice acting is real annoying.
Altitude is getting low. Pull back the control stick to ascend.
Aero Wings 2 is more or less the same game. They did change the graphics though, and they made the controls a little bit easier to use. However, I only think Flight Simulator fans should really pick these two games up. Both of them are going to get about a 6 out of 10 for me.
Target above you.
Unlike the last two games, Air Force Delta is not a flight sim. It's more of an arcadey air combat game. It reminds me of Crimson Skies on the original Xbox. It's a lot of fun, but only in short bursts. I would give this game a 7 out of 10. This launch game showed off the power of the Sega Dreamcast beautifully. You know, for the first time, a console game could easily pass for a live sports game. This is also one of the first football games that I've ever learned to love. Now, I'm not a big sports fan, and I know you might not be, but I would absolutely give this game a try. 10 out of 10. NFL 2K1 improves on its predecessor in almost every single way. Passing is easier, graphics are improved, and they added online play. This game is one of the best games on the Dreamcast. It's an easy 10 out of 10.
NFL 2K2 is the same game as 2K1, but with some minor improvements. Other than that, it's just some general roster changes. It's a 9 out of 10. NCAA 2K2 College Football is NFL 2K1's sloppy sister. This game is casual. This game is fun. And it's not serious at all. NFL Blitz. These games are a little bit more casual, a little bit more arcade style. Personally, I didn't like it. It was a bit too twitchy for me. But there are some people that rave about this game. 6.5 out of 10. NFL Blitz 2001 is an improvement, and it also supports the VGA cable, so the game looks much better. But overall, same gameplay. It's going to be a 6.5 out of 10. Nobody talks about this game, but I absolutely love it. The career mode was fantastic. And it's a multi-platform game, but it looked its best on the Sega Dreamcast. This game had a little bit of silliness and a really awesome fighting engine.
Dance is time today!
Ready to Rumble 2 takes a step back in almost every single way except for graphics. But at least now you can fight as Michael Jackson and Shaquille O'Neal. Personally, I would skip this game, and it's much worse, and it was a huge letdown.
The House of the Dead.
What an amazing launch game. This arcade perfect port is one of the best light gun games of all time.
I would give it 10 out of 10 easily, and I would highly recommend it to anyone who wants to play a fun game on the Sega Dreamcast.
The Typing of the Dead.
Now, Typing of the Dead is the same game, except you type everything instead of shooting your enemies. Now, this seems a little bit silly, and it is, but it's a lot of fun, and the game is kind of a typing simulator. It's going to be a 9 out of 10 for me. Mortal Kombat Gold. This game is easily skippable. It's not bad. There's just clearly better fighting games to play. And, 3D Mortal Kombat games have never really struck a chord with me. I much rather would have played Mortal Kombat 2 or 3. And, there's fun to be had, but there's just better games to play. This one's going to be a 6.5 out of 10. Expendable is a mindless shooter that's fun for about 30 minutes. You can play co-op if you'd like, but it's just okay. You know, what I would say is play this game in short bursts, and it might be for you, and it might not be. But if you've played one stage, it kind of feels like you've played them all. There's just something missing about this game that I wish that the developers could figure out. Tokyo Extreme Racer is an excellent game. Basically, how it works is you are on these really big, huge tracks that are around a city, lots of highways, and you find other racers that are in other street gangs, and you flash your headlights, and you race them. It's kind of like GTA, but with street racing, and it's an excellent game. It's not really a simulation, and it's not really arcadey. It just is in this really great spot right between those two, and this game is an 8 out of 10. TNN Hardcore Heat is a game a lot of people rave about, but I felt like it is just okay. I feel like, you know, there's some serious off-roading in this game, which makes it enjoyable. It is a launch game, so it's a little bit basic as far as the graphics go, and there's some fun to be had. It's not a bad game. It's just not a game that I really think is all that great. I just think that there are better games on the Dreamcast. This one's going to get a 6 out of 10 for me. Trick Style. This game is actually pretty fun. It's like snowboarding, but with hoverboards. So there are all these races, there's ways to build up and get tricks, and there's lugeing. There's a lot of fun to be had in this game, and I would highly recommend giving it a try. Now, later on in the game, in the single player, the computer players get really, really cheap, and it can get frustrating as all hell. I would highly recommend this game, and I would give it an 8 out of 10.
Whew! Now we're done with launch games. Let's start with the first generation Dreamcast games.
Hey, hey, come on over, have some fun with Crazy Taxi!
If you're watching this video, you've probably played this game, and it's absolutely amazing. It's one of my favorite games on the Dreamcast. The musical score is mostly Offspring, and it's one of those titles that inspired me to play electric guitar. I absolutely love this one. For me, this game is a 10 out of 10.
We're back! It's Crazy Taxi 2!
And it even got a sequel, but in this game, you can jump. It's more of the same, but it's an absolutely fantastic game. It's going to be another 10 out of 10. Dead or Alive 2. This game is absolutely fantastic, and it blew my frickin' mind when I got it when I was a kid. Everything looked so real, the music was awesome, had an amazing countering system. For me, this game, no question about it, 10 out of 10, and one of my favorite 3D fighters. Deep Fighter is not a great game. Personally, I thought it was kind of a waste of time. There are these weird videos that you watch sometimes, and it's like a space sim, but it's underwater, which sounds kind of cool. I thought maybe I'd be like shooting, you know, alien fishes or something like that, and I thought that would be cool. But it was just really boring, and the graphics aren't even all that great for a Dreamcast game. I would give this game 4 out of 10.
Dropped my first load, guys.
Dynamite Cop for the Sega Dreamcast. Now, this is a pretty fun game. There's just a couple of small issues. You know, the game's not very deep. It's a beat-em-up. And at the same time, it's very, very short. It's about 30-40 minutes. However, this game is hilarious. You know, there's all these little things that crack me up every time I play it. And it's generally a really fun game. I would highly recommend playing this game with a friend. Evolution is a dungeon crawler RPG for the Sega Dreamcast. It's decently fun. Get ready to grind, though. There are a lot of battles. However, when cutscenes do happen, all the characters really stand out, and there is some pretty fun dialogue. Evolution 2 keeps the same formula, but updates the visuals, and now there's full voice acting. However, it's only in Japanese. Combat seems to be much faster, and I haven't played as much of this version as I'd like, but I'd give it about the same score as Evolution 1. This game is so bad, it gave me an existential crisis. Absolute trash. Now, the Fighting Force series was based off of a canceled Streets of Rage game, and I loved Streets of Rage, and I was absolutely disappointed by this game. Don't even frickin' try it. Gauntlet Legends gets an award for being the only Dreamcast game with an email address on the title screen. All in all, a lot of fun, but more fun if you play it with other people. You can level up, you kill monsters. If you haven't played a Gauntlet game, you know, I would definitely give it a try. It's nothing too serious, but it's a lot of fun to be had. Grand Theft Auto 2. This game was definitely cool. I just wished it was in 3D. I don't even know if the Dreamcast could handle it, but that's all I wanted when I was a kid. It's just like all the other GTA games, but it's 2D. This game goes under the radar for a lot of people, but it's a solid 8 out of 10 game. The only thing that I would say is I wish they kind of beefed up the graphics a little bit for the Sega Dreamcast. It was also on the PlayStation, and it seems to have kind of PlayStation-style graphics. But the storyline and presentation are amazing.
For my transgression, I earned a new kind of reward. Agony. There was only one possible outcome.
Cast him in.
NBA 2K has amazing graphics, good gameplay, but it has its problems. Passing has some real kinks that need ironing out. To be honest, I don't know all the rules, so I get a lot of penalties. But I can tell it's a good game. NBA 2K gets an 8 out of 10. NBA 2K1 sports improved graphics, passing, and playability. These first-party sports games incorporate the best of pickup and play and simulation. For this game, it's going to be a 9 out of 10. NBA 2K2 is easily the best basketball game on the Dreamcast. This is a fine-tuned version of 2K1 with roster and other minor changes. Check it out. 10 out of 10. Psychic Force 2012. This game is a hidden gem of the Sega Dreamcast library. It is this anime-style Dragon Ball Z kind of fighting game. You can shoot projectiles, you can fly around, and I am really surprised that so few people even know this game exists. It is a fantastic game. The only thing that's bad about this game is I haven't found a way for it to support the VGA cable, so you have to play it in disgusting 480i. Rayman 2. Ubisoft was not messing around when they made this game. Now, I know this is a multi-platform game, but I'm pretty sure the Dreamcast version runs at 60 frames per second, and the PS2 runs at 30. And my god, this game is beautiful. But the storyline is a bit dark.
They've taken everything and reduced our people to slaves.
Especially for a kid's game. Soul Fighter. This game is the white trash of the Dreamcast library. And man, oh man, this old guy can talk. It was about 4 minutes long. You have to hear this old man babbling. And I'm sorry about this footage. I think I was crying the whole time I was recording it. And yeah, these graphics are that bad because it's in 480i. Very, very simple arcade style beat 'em up.
Humiliation.
You can pick up items. It's really not much to see here. Terrible. 4 out of 10. South Park's Chef's Love Shack. This is a game show game like Jeopardy or Wheel of Fortune with some South Park flair. Grab 4 of your best friends and have some fun. My favorite part were the minigames. It's going to be a 7 out of 10. This game is absolute garbage. It uses a checkpoint system that doesn't work and it doesn't register most of the time. They use a city layout and the checkpoints aren't clearly labeled, and sometimes you can lose your place. You'll be in first place and you go to last place. It seems like a layup because South Park characters are kind of cartoony, and the graphics actually don't look that bad. They fit the visual style, but it's absolutely terrible game. In this game, you play as Ulala, who is a reporter for Space Channel 5. This game is full of wacky aliens and other silly reporters. It is so much fun. It's like a dance style game, but you have to use the controller. Sometimes you have to go through the same levels over and over again to get the rhythms right, but I have a great sense of rhythm. I've been playing guitar for over 10 years, and I feel like there are some times where I've clearly made the correct rhythm, but this game is just a little bit broken. However, I think it's a fantastic game, and I would give it an 8 out of 10, and I absolutely love it. Speed Devils. Hey, you know, this game, it's bland, but it has its certain charm. It's very, very okay, but, you know, I like the look of the vehicles. I like the music. It's not going to win any awards, but this is a 7 out of 10 game. Now, what's really interesting is that there was a sequel on the Dreamcast, which was Speed Devils Online, so you could actually race people online, which is pretty damn cool. Now, I think there were some slightly different tracks, but for the most part, it was the same game. Super Magnetic Neo. This game was a Saturday morning cartoon 3D platformer. It's pretty damn funny, a lot of fun to play, and it really uses this interesting magnet system. Now, I wish it wasn't like an on-rails kind of 3D platformer. I wish it was more like Mario 64 where you could kind of go anywhere. But overall, it's a really good game and a hidden gem of the Dreamcast library. Although it looks cutesy as hell, it's actually surprisingly hard. I would give this game a 7.5 out of 10. Sword of the Berserk Guts Rage. There are a lot of things that I want to say about this game, and I actually want to review this game in its entirety, so I'm not going to say much here, but I will say it's an underrated title, and it's one of the better games on the Dreamcast.
Are you mercenaries? If so, you're strange ones.
Tag Romancer!
Capcom supported the hell out of the Dreamcast with odd titles like Tag Romancer. Check this one out. It's kind of like a Street Fighter game, but with mechs. The graphics are a bit basic, but I like the style. Yeah, there's a lot of these Capcom fighters. Time Stalkers Sports, an unlikely hero, and a very strange story with really interesting dialogue. What I would recommend is that you play this game if you like dungeon crawlers, and you like a little snarkiness in your RPG. I would say that this game is a 7.5 out of 10. There are some issues, like the camera angles are a little bit funky in the town, but overall, this is a decently fun game. In this game, you play as a kid who is imagining his toys coming to life. This game is definitely underrated and is usually never mentioned. This is a first generation game, so the polygon count is a bit low. But the visual style is top-notch. This game is really fantastic. I would try it if you're looking for a new Dreamcast game. The Virtua Fighter series has always broken new ground. Virtua Fighter 2 on the Sega Saturn is an absolute masterpiece. Virtua Fighter 3 TB on the Dreamcast updates the visuals and adds a dodge button. This game, by the time it came out, didn't look all that great, and it was just kind of meh. And Soul Calibur absolutely overshadowed this game. What I will say is it is a good game in its own way, but the Sega Dreamcast has so many amazing fighters that this game is easily forgotten. Although, I would give it a 7.5 out of 10.
Virtua Tennis!
This is the first sports game I ever liked. I absolutely loved this game when it came out. And at the time, the graphics were amazing and so polished. The engine in this game is superb, and it is great for gaming in short bursts. This game is underrated and definitely worth a try. This game's a 10 out of 10. Tennis 2K2 was the sequel, and now you can play as a lady. They even bumped up the graphics a little bit. It's another easy 10 out of 10. Virtual Lawn is one of those games that I loved when I was a kid, but now that I play it, I kind of understand why I liked it and why I don't like it now. It is a mech-style game, and I loved anime when I was a kid, but the controls are kind of terrible, even if you use the twin sticks. I never really felt like I could get good at this game, and this is one of those games that, you know, I felt like the Dreamcast really needed a second stick, although I absolutely adore the original Dreamcast controller. I think they should have came out with some sort of revision. I was excited to play this game, but I never really clicked with it. You play as a tank and you collect power-ups. You have to destroy everything in each level to progress. I think there's fun to be had in this game, but you can skip this one. This game needs more polish for my taste. I'm going to give it a 5 out of 10. Sega Bass Fishing. It's one of my favorite titles on the Dreamcast. And I know you might not believe me, but whip out a fishing controller and spend an afternoon on it. I gotta say, I've had some great times playing this game. The only thing that I would say about this game is that there aren't as many levels as I'd like, but it's an arcade game. What are you gonna do? You've cleared all the areas. Most people don't know that Sega Bass Fishing actually got a sequel. And that's probably for good reason, because this game sucks. And it takes pretty much everything the original did and made it worse. Very, very bland, uninteresting graphics, and the fishing is just not fun at all. I would give this a 3 out of 10. Sega Marine Fishing, however, now this is a sequel. This game was awesome, and it's almost as good as Sega Bass Fishing. I would say it's just a little bit worse, but it's still an 8 out of 10 game. Check it out. Real Fishing Wild is a joke. I cannot believe this game was even released. It's easily one of the worst titles on the Sega Dreamcast. I would give it a 2 out of 10.
Launch games and first generation games are done. Let's focus on the second generation of Dreamcast games.
I loved Shenmue for the Sega Dreamcast. A lot of people want to rag on this game these days. But when I played this in the year 2000, it was like looking through a time machine.
No, don't!
Hand over the mirror. Or else, your son.
It is amazing. I cannot believe these graphics happened on this console. And the vision of this game was absolutely amazing.
If Lan Di gets that mirror, no one can stop him.
And there are so many quotable moments.
That's why I'm looking for Chinese people that are members of the Three Blades.
Years ago, I was Chinese.
Not all Chinese people are bad.
I would wish I could spend 10 or 15 minutes talking about this game, but I've got to get moving on here.
Yeah? Do you want something to drink?
No thanks. I'd better go.
Oh, that's a shame.
Ryo, you just missed a life opportunity. That was a sure thing.
I won.
Jack Ryan Radio!
Oh my god. This game is absolutely one of the best games on the Dreamcast. It's an easy 10 out of 10 for me. I absolutely loved this game when I was a kid, and I spent hours trying to make my own graffitis. Yeah, there are so many videos and so much information on this game, I'm just gonna leave it at that.
Yeah! Yeah! Nice!
What can I say about this game that you cannot say about crack cocaine? I have spent so much time on this game. I've invested at least hundreds of hours into it. I can't really get into this game as much as I'd like, but I have made so many characters and I've played with so many people on the internet. This game is absolutely fantastic. It's gonna be a 10 out of frickin' 10. Phantasy Star Online version 2 is more of the same, but now you can go up to level 200 and play on the difficulty level Ultimate. Check it out. 10 out of 10. This game is so good, it's not even funny. It's one of the best RPG games on any console, and I wish I could make a whole video on this game alone. The characters, the art direction, storyline, themes, music, airships, and everything else I'm missing is so absolutely original, I can't even overstate how awesome it is. Please play this game. It's gonna be another 10 out of 10.
Samba de Amigo!
One of my absolute favorites on the Sega Dreamcast. 10 out of 10, no questions asked. The music, the style, and everything is perfect. You have to play this game with maracas to truly appreciate it. It's a masterpiece. I cannot overstate how amazing this game is. Bite the bullet and buy the maracas. Worth every single penny. This is an arcade-style driving game. I personally love the game, and I love the feel of it. Pick your favorite 18-wheeler driver and go to town. Basically, what you do is you drop off loads, and the game's pretty short. If it were longer, I'd probably give it a higher score, but it's still definitely worth trying. I give it a 7.5 out of 10. Alien Front Online is actually a graphically impressive game for the Dreamcast. It has arena-style gameplay with tanks, or alien tanks if you play as aliens. I never played it online, but it does support voice chat, which was a groundbreaking thing in the year 2000. I felt like this game could have been a real heavy hitter. It could have been top tier on the Dreamcast. It just falls short because it's a bit too basic. All in all, it's a good game, and I would love to play this online. Bomberman Online, yet another game I've never played on the internet. I've got to say, Bomberman is a classic, and if you haven't tried a Bomberman game, you are truly missing out. Get a couple of friends and have a great night. It's going to be an 8 out of 10. Cannon Spike is one of the most expensive games on the Dreamcast, and for good reason. This game is a lot of fun. It's like a shoot 'em up, except you can rotate around your enemies and lock on. But, much like most other arcade-style games, this game is not very deep. I'd give it an 8 out of 10. Confidential Mission. This is a very goofy light gun game, and you should really check out the storyline. You play this pseudo-James Bond character, and there's all these little in-game jokes. I would highly recommend trying it out, and I wish I had more time to talk about it. 8 out of 10. Just like Virtua Fighter 3 TB, Daytona USA was better on the Saturn. This game is not bad, but personally, it's just not one of my favorites, and I'd rather boot up my Saturn. The game looks great, but the music's worse. I really miss that soundtrack. I'd give this one a 7.5 out of 10. I got this game when I was a kid, and I was blown away by the graphics. Everything looked so real, and this is essentially an underwater Zelda. This really was an amazing game. Just swimming around is fun, but there are puzzles and challenges, and it's one of the best games on the Dreamcast for sure. 9 out of 10. To be honest, I haven't actually played much of Grandia 2. I've started it at least 3 times, so I have that going for me. But from what I've played, this is a great game. Unfortunately, Skies of Arcadia just overshadows it. Something that's really interesting is that this game features full voice acting. This RPG is gonna get 8 out of 10. Who are you? I haven't seen you around. I really wanted to like this game, because I played it on a demo disc when I was a kid and I loved it. But when I play it now, it just was a huge, huge letdown. The music is atrocious. So don't wait till tomorrow comes, 'cause I'll be long gone. I guess it's not that bad, but it's terrible for a racing game. What's unique about this game is that it uses a kudos system instead of your lap times, which sounds fun, but I really just want to drive fast and not worry about style as much. This game is a blast. It's an online multiplayer that I haven't played on the internet. There are all these different characters, and there are these fun games like Smack Kahuna and soccer. It takes a bit of a learning curve, but you can ride boars, you can do all these different things, and it's definitely worth checking out. It's going to be an 8 out of 10 game for me. All in all, the Sega Smash Pack Volume 1 is a disappointment, and it's a disappointment because most of the games are emulated on this compilation and they don't sound like their original systems. That might be due to the Dreamcast not being quite powerful enough to emulate them perfectly, but we'll never know. What I think is that this is not a great game compilation, but it does have some decent games like Virtua Cop 2, which was released independently in Japan. Another game on here that's worth checking out is Sega Swirl. Now, you can play this game against other people online, but you have to email them or know their email address. Sega Swirl is going to get a 6 out of 10 for me. It's a bit too easy, but it's enjoyable in short bursts. Sega Smash Pack, however, is going to get a 6.5 out of 10. Silent Scope. The problem with arcade ports is that although they're a lot of fun, they are not very deep. And that is the problem with Silent Scope. The game's not very deep, but it's a fun ride while it lasts. I don't think the light gun works with this game, and I don't think they made a long gun either. So you're going to have to stick to the controller. But you can still have a lot of fun. I'm going to give this a 7.5 out of 10.
Welcome to the laboratory of Jean-Paul Gasset.
Seaman turns your TV into an aquarium. It's voiced by Leonard Nimoy, and yeah, he's from Star Trek. And it's also Seaman, not Seaman. Anyways, this game uses the microphone on the Sega Dreamcast, and the first 5 days are boring as hell. You can use a little trick and play around with the Dreamcast internal clock to speed up time. It takes forever for them to hatch, and if you're like me, you'll get bored, even if you adjust the date and time. I'm hesitant to give this one a rating because it's kind of such a unique game, but I'll give it a 7 out of 10. It's definitely worth trying.
Whew, let's keep moving forward. The next section, survival horror, my favorite.
Resident Evil 2 is one of the best survival horror games of all time. And in my opinion, the version on the Dreamcast is one of the best games of all time.
We can't stay out here. Head to the police station. It'll be a lot safer.
Why is this game so good? Well, I could have a video series talking about how. But I have beaten this game so many times. I have gone through every single scenario. And it's the best way to play the original version of the game. It took everything that happened on the PlayStation and made it better. Better graphics, more options and features. Try it out.
You'll be in danger if you stay with me.
Resident Evil. Everybody has their own opinion, but Resident Evil 3 is almost as good as Resident Evil 2. The voice acting is better, and the action is just tense. The fact that Nemesis just chases you around this game makes it really, really tough to progress.
You're saved.
Down here!
Huh?
Resident Evil Code Veronica is a great game. When I first saw this FMV, it just blew me away. Now, I think that this game is an 8.5 out of 10. But, to be honest, I think this is where the series started to go downhill. A little bit. Keep in mind, I'm giving this an 8.5 out of 10. The story just took a nosedive, and the characters weren't as strong. I will say this, I definitely enjoyed playing it, and the puzzles are amazing. Some of the best in the series. But the storyline is what drives the gameplay, and I felt like this game had a really, really weak plot.
Long time no see, Chris.
Except this part was awesome.
Wesker?
Alone in the Dark.
Alone in the Dark looks like an amazing game. And from what I've played, it is. The only thing I would say about this game is I haven't played it enough. But I've played about the first couple hours, and I've got to say, I'm very surprised that more people don't talk about this game. It's an absolute hidden gem. I'm going to give it an 8 out of 10.
Leave me be.
Look, just try to stay calm. I'll go and find help.
Run.
I'll be back.
Carrier.
I was excited to give this one a try, but I was really disappointed. The storyline is overly complicated, the monsters are not scary, and there is a lot of backtracking. I don't think that this is a good game. Now, I need to try it a couple more times, but I'm pretty sure that this is a 5.5 or 6 out of 10 game. D2. This is a weird game. D was released on the Sega Saturn, and it's one of those movie FMV games where you walk around, but you're on these planes. D2 is a little bit different, but you can see how it evolved from that. And there is a lot to talk about here. It's an absolutely bizarre game. Personally, I think it's awesome, but a lot of people give this one negative reviews, and I can see why. It's a little bit rough around the edges. But if you have time and patience, it's a great game. I would give this a 7 out of 10. Around this time, Resident Evil was all the rage, and Capcom loves to capitalize on crazes. Dino Crisis is the same idea as Resident Evil, but with dinosaurs.
That's disgusting.
This game is a little bit different in its own way. There isn't as much item management, and everything is rendered. 8 out of 10. This game has the setup to be awesome. It had awesome voice acting, a great story, and even copies the Resident Evil series. It just falls short in so many ways. All the enemies regenerate every time you beat them, and you can never really explore or discover the surrounding areas. This one's gonna get a 4 out of 10.
Humiliation.
Alright, I'm gonna get some hate for this one, but I have never really liked this game, and also kind of just don't understand it. Basically, you play this purple-haired girl, and you go into these movies, and you have to, you know, kill or beat the serial killer or mass murderer in that movie, and there's all these traps you need to avoid. It seems really campy, and usually that's a good thing, but I kind of don't understand it. You don't have a health bar. You have, you know, your heart rate monitor. You have, you know, hearing, smell. I've tried this game a couple of times and just haven't been able to wrap my head around it. Personally, this is a 5.5 out of 10 game for me. I want to give it a couple more tries, but it's just never clicked. When I was younger, I saw ads for this game in magazines, and I always wanted to try it. Now that I've played it, it's very, very clunky. Very choppy animation, it doesn't support the VGA cable, and the story is just kind of trash. Yeah. All in all, this is a really bad game. 3 out of 10.
Humiliation.
The Ring, Terror's Realm. This game is not great, but I like it. It's going to get a 6.5 out of 10, but a lot of people really rag on this game, and they say it's one of the worst games on the Dreamcast. I think it's just a really unique survival horror game. It carries the same storyline as the movie. If you ever watch that video, you're gonna die in 7 days. And basically, you have to solve this mystery. And there are some creepy things that happen. I would give this game a try. Zombie Revenge is not a survival horror game, but it has zombies, so let's talk about it. It's a beat-em-up with a lot of charm. There are also some highly quotable moments.
There's no time antidote. Bullets. Bullets.
Here, take this! A man with golden eyes said to give it to you.
Alright, let's keep going. Extreme sports.
Tony Hawk's Pro Skater. If you lived in the 90s, you played this game. I've beaten this game so many times. I highly recommend this game if you haven't had a chance to play it. The soundtrack in this game is absolutely amazing, and I knew many people in high school who started a band because they liked the music so much. I even started playing electric guitar because of this game. 10 out of frickin' 10. And it got a sequel. How about that? And Tony Hawk's Pro Skater 2 is different in its own ways. You collect money, you collect cash, you can buy points, you can buy stats. Absolutely fantastic game. Same deal. 10 out of 10. Fantastic game. Dave Mirra's Pro BMX cashes in on the Tony Hawk craze, but does a fantastic job. The graphics are a bit basic, but the soundtrack is absolutely amazing. I'm gonna give this one a 7.5 out of 10. Matt Hoffman's Pro BMX is a great spin-off of the Tony Hawk series. The gameplay here is better than Dave Mirra, but the soundtrack is worse. All in all, both are great games. Four Evolution. This game you can play online against other people. I think this game is about a 7.5 or 8 out of 10. There is some fun to be had, and I like the racing style. You can kind of go off-roading. Personally, I haven't played this game all that much, but it seems great. Championship Surfer. This game seems to be wanting to cash in on that Tony Hawk craze. I've never really liked surfing games because you're very limited to what you can do. You're kind of always waiting for the waves. Personally, this game's not all that great. 6 out of 10. This game is absolute trash. 1 out of 10. The worst graphics, worst frame rate that I've seen on the Sega Dreamcast. Please avoid this game. Wow, this game is a heaping pile of trash. It's one of the worst games on the Sega Dreamcast. And just take a look at these terrible graphics. My question is, if this is MTV's Andy McDonald skateboarding, why does the music suck so much? And why is it so bad?
Humiliation.
Ah yeah, the year 2000. Everybody tried to replicate the magic that was Tony Hawk's Pro Skater. This one falls short, but not by much. It's actually pretty fun. I would highly recommend trying it out if you like Tony Hawk's Pro Skater. It's going to be a 6.5 out of 10. Some people really like Rippin' Riders, and I don't really care for it all that much. I really wanted to like this game, and I was really hoping it would be like SSX Tricky, but I was just really bored of it. There are areas where you can do tricks, and there's areas where you do racing, but this one just doesn't have any magic for me. This is going to be a 5.5 out of 10.
Sports Jam!
This game was ported straight from the arcade, and it's a lot of fun. It's a mini game compilation, and this guy looks frickin' weird. You pick 3 stages, and then hopefully if you beat them all, you go to a final stage. You might know some of these games, like this is basketball, there's a tennis game, but you kind of have to relearn the game because it's about lining up the crosshairs rather than, you know, aiming. You have to really just wait, and it's kind of like darts in Shenmue. But the good news is that most of these games are actually kind of fun. and I would say this game is an easy 8 out of 10. Racing on water in jet skis. Sounds fun, but this game is very average. You can have fun playing it, but it's easily forgettable. You might as well play something else like Hydro Thunder. At least then, you know you'll have some fun. This game is a 6 out of 10. Suzuki All-Star Extreme Racing. This game is a hidden gem. It doesn't look like much, but it's got it where it counts. This game is an easy 8 out of 10. I tell you, you gotta try this game out. It looks really simple, but it's so much fun. What extreme sports section is not gonna have extreme sports for the Sega Dreamcast? This game really should be called Extreme Sports Triathlon. So you go between all these different extreme sports, and although it's a really cool idea, the implementation of it is really bad. Though the Dreamcast is pushing some polygons here. I would try it out, but don't get your hopes up too high. It's gonna be a 5.5 out of 10.
The next section is gonna be third and first person shooters.
Quake 3 Arena. This is the first person shooter game I really liked. This game has amazing gameplay. It's all about running around, finding enemies, and shooting them. It's so much fun. There's a lot of interesting weapons, and if you have some friends, you can play online or local. It is so much fun. My favorite weapon's gotta be the rocket launcher.
Humiliation.
This game is an 8.5 out of 10. Unreal Tournament is very similar to Quake 3 Arena, except there's alternate fire weapons and the graphics are a little bit better. However, the frame rate has some chug, so watch out. But this is still an 8 out of 10 game for me. Sega tried to make their own arena-style first-person shooter, but it came out as a third-person shooter. This game is another amazing game on the Sega Dreamcast library, and I would give this a 9 out of 10. The only issue that I have with it is that the arenas are a little bit too small. Army Men Sarge's Heroes could be a great game. If they beefed up the graphics a little bit, added strafing, and did some other minor tweaks. I'm going to give this a 6.5 out of 10. Give it a try. Imagine Quake 3 Arena and Banjo-Kazooie had a child, and it wasn't that great. That would be Fur Fighters. I personally love this game, and I played it on a demo disc when I was a kid, and I thought it was awesome. And it is okay. I would give it a 7 out of 10, but don't expect too much from this one. But it definitely has some charm. Gundam Side Story 0079. This game I actually want to like, and I've tried it a few times, but I've never really clicked with it. It's a first-person shooter, but inside a mech. Everything just feels slow, and I don't know, the draw distance is terrible. What I would say is give this one a try, but don't have high expectations.
Spawn.
I'm gonna be honest, I was really excited to play this one. The artwork and action looks so cool, and I love the graphics, but the camera is terrible. It's hard to follow the action. I don't recommend this game, but I can understand why you want to try it. It's going to be a 3 out of 10 for me.
Humiliation.
Heavy Metal Geomatrix. This is an arcade-style game where everyone is a rock star, or at least a burnt-out singer. You can run around a la Power Stone and pick up guns, swords, and jetpacks. It's simple, but fun. I didn't expect this game to be that great, but it's like a better version of Spawn. I'm going to give it an 8 out of 10. Kiss Psycho Circus. I hate this game. I hate it because I like Kiss, and I like first-person shooters. But this game has nothing to do with Kiss. The music's not even Kiss. You're not even playing a Kiss character. I can't even tell if he's actually the lead singer, guitarist, drummer, bassist. I don't even know who this character is. It gives you no information. The background doesn't seem to have anything to do with the band Kiss. Why is this called Kiss Psycho Circus? There isn't even a circus in the game. I don't understand it. Easy, 2 out of 10, and one of the worst games on the Sega Dreamcast. Soldier of Fortune for the Sega Dreamcast is a fantastic game. There are a couple issues, but overall, the graphics, the voice acting, the story, and environments are all pretty good. This game's biggest problem is the load times. There are so many load times, and they're very long. The first load time is about 2 minutes long, and honestly, it ruins the game quite a bit.
So I have some bad news, guys. This is part one of two. In this video, there are only about 120 games. Now, I wish I could have had all of the games done by September 9th, 2019. The issue is that I had an 8 terabyte hard drive die, and I lost some footage. And at the same time, also had to upgrade the size of my hard drive on my MacBook. So there have been some setbacks. But I have spent countless hours on this video recording footage, writing down my thoughts and notes in general. And what I want to say is, if you like this video, if you like the Dreamcast, go ahead and leave a comment. Just tell me your favorite game, tell me a game you want me to talk about, and please subscribe and like the video. I'll see you guys next time.